Hello. Today I'm going to present you with this short video clip the project I and my team have been working on during this semester. It consists in designing, from A to Z, 5 specific subsystems of the suborbital shuttle of the Aerospace Student Challenge Team. This shuttle is designed to transport 8 persons maximum to the limit of our atmosphere in order to experience 3 to 4 minutes of weightlessness. The 5 subsystems are the piloting board, the anti-crash seats, the rudders, the landing gears, and the holding system between the shuttle and its carrying airplane. Our project started quite naturally with the definition of tasks and planning, using SADT diagrams. From these diagrams, we were able to define our working schedule. The very first step of our project's development was to do as much research as we could on existing and related systems. This was an essential step since it was the robust basis on which we built the rest of the project. Then, before even thinking about the technical solutions for our systems, we defined the needs they had to conform to. To do so, we realized a detailed functional analysis, specifying for each product to whom it will serve, on what it will act, its use, its characteristic functions, the external and internal elements it will interact with, and so on. Our aim being developing innovative systems, we used 3 different innovation methods: spontaneous creation, CK method, and morphologic method. Thus, we obtained very different concepts, giving us a wide choice range for our final product. As future engineers, in order to perform that choice, we realized a full research on potential technical solutions. Therefore, using our specifications worksheet on one hand, these potential technical solutions and our preconcepts on the other, we chose our final concept for each of our products. We then combined a CAD representation with finite element strain studies for most critical parts. We finally had the opportunity to think about the industrialization step of one of these products, the landing gears. This project, the very first of its kind in our academic curriculum, let us discover the main development steps of a product as it would be realized in a professional background. The relative important size of the team and the organization of our work made this project a unique and very intense experience that I think we all learned a lot from.